A video deposition has become a key piece of evidence in the civil trial over the death of pop star Michael Jackson. As Eyewitness News reporter Miriam Hernandez tells us, Katherine Jackson's lawyers are playing the tape as they grill a top AEG executive for a third day in a row.
Michael Jackson's tour was a sellout. Had he lived, attorneys for his family say in court today, the superstar's future earnings could have topped $1 billion. Jurors have viewed Jackson performing. For the last week, they have also viewed clips of this man.
So you've never seen this email before?
No, I don't recall writing this email.
It's a video deposition of Paul Gongewares, co-CEO for AEG Live, a defendant in the lawsuit. He is responding here to questions about an email. The plaintiffs say it shows AEG hired Dr. Conrad Murray, the physician whose treatments for insomnia led to Jackson's death.
It says, "We want to remind him that it is AEG, not MJ, who is paying his salary." What... In that sentence, where it says AEG, what were you referring to?
I don't remember what I was referring to.
The plaintiffs play clips that highlight how the defendant's answers change. In one shown today, Gongewares is canceling Jackson's insurance for the tour, saying, "If we don't get sickness coverage, we are dropping the policy." In the video, jurors hear a familiar phrase.
I don't remember it.
Yet today, Gongewares says he does remember now, testifying that the health coverage wasn't worth it and that it would require a medical exam that Jackson didn't want. According to legal analyst Barry Edwards, the aim of the Jackson attorneys is to raise a trust question.
If you attack someone's credibility, it tells the jury that this person is really not somebody whose testimony should be followed.
The Jackson attorneys say AEG's conduct shows that there was an implicit contract between AEG and Murray, even though no deal was signed. Gongewares' testimony? That Jackson hired Murray and that none of the emails or alleged warnings had anything to do with his death, he said, which was the result of an overdose of the sedative propofol. Miriam Hernandez, ABC 7, Eyewitness News.